Wim's Method by Wim Hof. These exercises should be done with heart and conviction to reach the depth of understanding. Only then will you see the effects of the technique. I have learned to breathe differently in cold water immersions. It is a natural process simply because of the impact you must adapt. You learn to breathe more consciously, deeper, and more effectively. Exercise number one, breathing. Note, when I put easy in parentheses, I am emphasizing that I do not want you to force the explained technique. It is important to stay comfortable and not overexert yourself. Practicing will push you a little more each time. Just try to stay relaxed. Don't force it. Sit comfortably in a peaceful environment, like a bedroom, living room, backyard, in nature, whatever suits you. Now, I'll mention, you also want to do this in a safe environment. Don't do this any place where you would be in danger, like in a pool or driving. Then, relax consciously and begin to breathe from the abdominal region. Not too shallow, not too deep. Think of it like blowing up a balloon. Do this 30 times. Saturate the muscles and organs with extra oxygen. The goal is to let the oxygen saturate not only the lungs, but also all of the internal organs. It may feel like you're hyperventilating, but just remember that you have control. Whenever you feel saturation throughout the body, exhale completely, easy. Then inhale until you can't take in any more air. Don't force it. Then exhale completely, easy, and hold your breath, easy. When the feeling telling you to breathe comes, it is because of the depletion of oxygen. At this point, you can inhale fully and hold it for 10 seconds with your lungs full of air. When you complete that, you've completed your first cycle. Then, repeat. By practicing this, over time you will be able to hold each breath longer and get deeper into your system, like your immune system, nervous system, blood circulation, and heart. After each retention, which is the holding of the breath, and inhalation, close your eyes. You may be able to see electrical charges. Some categorize these lights as chakras, electric potentials, or even neurons firing. If you go deep inside yourself, you can stimulate this electricity by a pneumatic pressure that goes up the spine toward your forehead. Oxygen aids the metabolism in creating energy for the body to circulate through your system. When you empty the lungs of oxygen, hold for retention until you can't anymore. Then inhale. Doing this will give the body new oxygen laced with boosts of energy. This provokes the electricity to go up the spine, reaching the nervous system, immune system, blood circulation, and heart, thus ending up in your forehead and influencing the brain effectively. Exercise 2, meditation. Yoga is the silencing of the mind. Only then can we really see the peace inside ourselves. It's no hocus pocus. The breathing exercise written above will help you get there. To reach the forehead and see the electrical charges, you must not only be patient and practice, but you must really want it. Controlling the mind is controlling your senses and emotions. When you can do that, anything is possible. By anything, I mean you will be able to still your mind and steer by the intentions to induce the lights. Once you're able to induce the lights, you will see that the technique is working. Your body will feel lighter and more powerful. This technique can calm your mind and make it pure. A pure mind can easily expand and reach its potential. That is when the light will become clear. I could talk about this forever, but what is important is that you truly want to do it. Practice it. That way, you'll come to know and understand the true nature of the spirit. Abhyasa Bhairaga Bhyaga, which means regular practice and perseverance. And I believe that there is Sanskrit. Exercise 3, cold exercises. It's like I always say, the cold is a noble force. If people ask me what I mean by that, I tell them, the cold forces me to generate heat, makes me feel alive. I see the heat as a warm friend whom I call upon to provide balance. Every yin has its yang. The cold is about balance and moderation. Exercise 3.1, adaptation. The first thing you should try doing is taking a cold shower after a hot one. Try to control your breaths as you face the impact of the cold on your lungs. Try to consciously control the lungs to not gasp and breathe at ease. When you're able to do this, you've taken a gigantic step in being able to consciously control the vascular system around your vital organs. Regularly practicing cold showers can lead to muscle development in your arteries. The entire vascular system altogether will be conditioned as you exercise. But let things adapt. Don't force yourself through it. Stay determined, yet patient. Once the adaptation process is complete, you can move on to the next phase, which is taking a cold shower without a warm one. You will need to be determined for this as well. Before you even begin your cold shower, you may notice a drop in your body temperature. Due to your intentions of taking the cold shower, your body will react psychosomatically. It is all part of the process. Once again, when you get in the shower, breathe controlled and let the adaptation happen naturally. you will gain the best results and best control over the body when you are completely relaxed. Eventually, you'll be able to steer the mind to consciously control the autonomic nervous system. If you try to force it, your body will fight back and try to block you from making any progress. This happens because your body isn't used to taking the impact of the cold. Once you adapt in this stage, you will feel much stronger. Some have reported an unexpected feeling of happiness, but most of all, your body's cardiovascular system will begin to run much smoother. Learn to like the cold, and you will naturally feel different and eventually have the desire to immerse yourself in a cold environment during the wintertime. Exercise 3.2, visualization. In stage 1 and 2, we learned to adapt and began controlling the body with the mind. Now, we'll learn how to control the mind and body using the power of visualization. Remember, never force anything. Let your intuition guide you. Always listen to what your body is telling you. The next time you go to perform a cold exercise, like the cold shower, I would like you to visualize heat generating within your body just before you enter. Hopefully, you will notice that it brings a sensation of warmth and control. With every breath, intensify this sensation and keep your mind focused on the heat. Don't let it stray away. We can do this with our mind by reconditioning our way of thinking. It's important to focus on the sensation and not dwell on other matters. In time, this focus will come naturally to you. Once you can feel and control the heat, go into the cold water and control your breathing. Immerse with the power of the mind over the body. When you first get in, you may notice a gasping response. Try to control this, and then peacefully adapt to the water. Continue to keep your mind focused on the heat sensation. Stay in the cold water for as long as it feels comfortable. As soon as you feel any sort of pain or feel uneasiness, get out. When you get out of the water, you'll probably see steam coming off of your body. This is a good thing and a nice result of your focused mind and proper visualization. Remember, never force. Let your body guide your training and only do what you're comfortable with. Exercise 3.3, sitting outside. Another cold exercise that you can do is practice sitting outside in cold temperatures. By using your newly conditioned body that you've developed during the first few stages, you should be able to now visualize a warm sensation coming from the abdominal region. Hopefully, this will allow you to comfortably sit in the snow and control your inner temperature. It is up to you to figure out how long you can sit there. It is extremely important that you do not force it. Now that you've taught yourself how to control the internal temperature of your body, you can attempt to increase your endurance and lengthen the amount of time that you can remain exposed to the cold temperatures. Exercise 3.4, barefoot snow walking or running. Another cold exercise you can try is walking or running barefoot through the snow. You will find great power when walking and running through the snow without footwear. It is a wonderful sensation. After you've completed the first few stages of the cold exercises, you will begin to understand the body at a whole new level. The heat sensation can be powerful. While you control that, you can simultaneously stimulate the autonomic nervous system. It is something that the Western society once thought was impossible. Usually, people will enter cold environments fully clothed and think that the cold has negative repercussions on the body. Without experience, it is hard for one to understand how the cold can positively affect the physiological processes of our body, including the immune system. The cold has the power to show us true human potential, if we let it. Training and natural adaptation in the cold brings about great differences in blood circulation. We have to consider this carefully because we now have a way to increase the efficiency of our body's physiological processes. Everything we consume is processed to stimulate the metabolism to give the body energy. Without an efficient system, the arteries can become clogged and the body can slowly shut down the vital organs. The cold has a positive effect on all of our bodies. It is our teacher. As you adapt, the muscles in the cardiovascular system are conditioned. The muscles contract and open, thus becoming stronger. When the muscles in the cardiovascular system get stronger, they improve the blood flow throughout the body and press it toward the finest threads of the blood circulative system. This also increases the efficiency of the heart because it doesn't need to pump as hard to force blood throughout the body. The cold feeds the immune system in the best possible way, keeping it alert and awake. With this newly utilized energy, the immune system can detect disease, specifically the inflammatory marked bodies, and immediately fix the problem. A lot of the Western society suffers from a weakened circulation system, therefore causing heart attacks, strokes, arthritis, and more. This method is a way to fix that problem and begin to improve the efficiency of the body. By practicing in the cold, you will learn to breathe deeper. Breathing is also an important factor in influencing the body in order to prevent possible diseases. It can be used to redirect blood flow and maintain warmth. It also helps focus our attention on what our body is trying to tell us. Never force your practice and listen to your intuition. It is one of the few ways to bridge the gap between our inner nature and outer nature. At times, we could be overprotective when it comes to deciding what is bad for us. Therefore, we miss out on influences like the cold that have the potential to help us grow. It is possible to be one with nature, yet maintain a normal lifestyle as you do now. With this method, I hope you can go about your daily lives while using your body's full potential. Just find the time to practice it, and your body will live efficiently. We all are capable of using this ability. It is a learning process that we must ease ourselves into. Your body and mind will adapt when you're ready. I'd like to make one final note. You don't have to subject your body to extreme temperatures. You can see big changes in your system by simply implementing cold showers into your daily life. This is definitely applicable to those that are reaching old age and their cardiovascular system is suffering. These cold showers will help your body remain in great condition. This training will help keep the heart, body, and mind in shape. That is the purpose of this technique. Nothing less. Good luck, Wim Hof.